Hello friends, for today I would like to show you a video of how to assemble and disassemble this headlight switch. Now this headlight switch came from a SYM Jet 100 model 2000. It's a headlight switch. The reason why I wanted to show this video is that it's getting harder and harder to look for parts for the SYM Jet 100 or the Jet 100. The reason is it's an obsolete bike. It's already phased out, and much more modern models have come out. So for those who still have it, and you might find this video useful, I will show you how to assemble and disassemble this. Now, the reason why I've been assembling and disassembling this switch is I've been having a hard time turning on the headlight. Sometimes when I turn it on like this, the headlight won't turn on, and I need to move the switch around like this, and I realize that the contacts must be dirty or they're just bad. So I'm going to show you how to assemble and disassemble it. Now you need something small, like this small flathead screwdriver. There are tabs on the side, right here and right there and there. So the first thing I always do is try to just loosen this part up. See, that's fine. And then this one there, that's fine. And this one. Okay, next is this one on the side. Gently pry it open. There is actually a space there that you can put your little screwdriver on. And also here. And that will pop this assembly out. Now, I've already bought a new switch, so it's okay if you see anything broken in this. That's also the reason why I bought a new switch, is because I've been cleaning it all the time. I've been cleaning it more than once, and I've broken this tab right here. It still works, but you know, it's broken. So I decided to look for a switch. Luckily I did find one, so that one is already on the motorcycle. This one is extra. Okay, so here are the parts. Here is practically the bottom part, and this one is the top part, the top connectors. Now I'm just going to use this as an example because they're practically the same. This one and this one is practically the same. This is shiny already because I've cleaned it, but you might find your switch to be dirty. It's going to be a little bit darker, like some of these colors right here. You're going to need some sandpaper and just gently scratch them up until they become shiny again. You may want to squirt some light oil. Usually WD-40 is fine, or any kind of oil, and you just scratch it up until they become shiny again. Now for this part, it's a little bit more complicated. Now be very careful with this part. This one, that's a ball bearing that makes you move your switch and holds it on that position. It locks it in that position. That ball bearing locks it in that position. Okay, so there's a pivot point right here. You will make sure you put your finger in there, because that ball bearing is gonna pop out. And if that falls on the ground and bounces away, you will have a hard time finding it. Ask me how I know. Anyway, so there's the ball bearing. Okay, I'll put it somewhere safe. And here are the contact points on the switch. Now, actually, my problem on my motorcycle or on my switch was these. Okay, when I first disassembled this, they were already fused together like so. They were fused to the switch like this. The springs weren't able to push them out anymore, and they should have a play like this. I don't know if you can see it from the camera, but they should have a play like this. Should move up and down like that. Okay, so how do you take that out? If you can see, there's like grooves here and grooves here. Now, the first time I pulled this out, I just literally pried them out, and I was lucky enough that I didn't break it, but there's a proper way of doing it. It's actually, you're going to twist it. You're going to twist it. They can, you can twist this until they pop off. Twist, twist, twist. There you go. It's popping out now. There you go. So all you had to do is twist it. Now, if you can see on the camera, I'm trying to move. I hope you can see it, but there's actually grooves there, and then it's circular part right here. And that's how you attach it back. I'll show it you later. I won't disassemble this part. They're practically the same. Okay. If you see here, it's shiny already. Again, I just used some sandpaper and just scratched it up. Now the spring, what I did was added some oil, and then gently, very gently, I started pulling them out. Just pulling them out until maybe one or two coils. I don't know if you can see it, but one or two coils. Come on, back up there. Focus, focus, focus. There you go. About one or two coils will pop out. And then you assemble it. So assembling is opposite of what you just did. Oops. Okay, so you put it this way first. That way. The two dots will appear vertically. And then twist. Like a cap. Oops. There's actually a groove those tabs will hook onto, and there you go. And if you do it right, see, they're not gonna fall off right there. So just be gentle, and when you're using, when you're assembling it, because this one is plastic and this one is metal, and plastic and metal, when they rub together, usually the plastic loses. So just be very gentle with it. So that's what you need. You need them to go up and down like that. Okay, the spring here, not really that much important. I didn't try to, well, I did. I did pry it out a little bit, but not too much, because the ball bearing will fit exactly inside there. Okay, I did the same with these. Now, I broke the tabs already, as you can see. This is actually one piece. Okay, so once you back this part back in, now you're going to put the lever back in. Now there is a little pole wherein this thing will fit in, but don't put it all the way back in yet. You're going to need this corner to put your ball bearing in. Okay, so I find it easier to just slip it in there in that corner. I hope you can see it. It's right there. And then gently align it along the spring. And then as you push down, you use your flathead screwdriver to push it towards its notch. So you're pushing down and pushing that ball bearing inside the notch. There you go. There you go. So there it is. You're almost done at this point. All you need now is to attach the back plate, or this cover right here. So once you got it all aligned, put it back in until you hear the snap. Then top part, do the same thing, and there you go, you got it all back. Then function check. There has to be positive clicks on all three positions. So this is off, this is park light, and this is headlight, and there you go. It's very simple, and I hope this video helps somebody. Bye.